Hey guys, and welcome back to Hang 10.
I'm Kayla, and this is Molly. We are so excited about today.
We really are. You guys started sending in your ideas for the Challenge of All Challenges! And they are awesome.
Yeah, they are. I actually have some of them on my cards here. Do you want to split them up to share?
Oh, yeah. You go first.
Okay, the first idea is world's best homemade boat.
That could be interesting.
Yeah.
Just don't sink, okay? Polar plunge.
Too cold.
No.
Nope, not for me. Okay, world's best finger tutter.
What is that?
I don't know. That looks like you're spraying perfume. Or sanitizer.
Yes, if it's sanitizer, we are doing
it. Tut away.
Google it, let us know. Ice bucket challenge.
Nope, too cold, can't do it. No. Okay, a challenge to make the best craft.
Yes, I do like that.
You're crafty.
I do like that. Okay. I have some crafty kids. We can do that. Yes.
Okay.
All right, the coolest fort. Yes.
Ooh, could it be a pillow fort?
Yes, okay, I like that one.
Okay, okay. Best Fortnite dance move.
No.
No.
I'm over Fortnite. No more Fortnite in this house. No. Craziest hairstyle.
Yes, that's so fun.
That is fun.
Okay, I like that one.
Okay.
Coolest toothbrush challenge. Do you know what that means?
Like brushing your teeth?
Like to a song?
Yes, children, you need to brush your teeth. Let's do that one.
And floss.
The longest slip and slide.
Ooh.
That could be cold. Again, I have all the cold ones.
Cold or fun. Okay. Oh, okay, what about this one? Raw egg toss. See how far apart you can be. No. You think that's too gross?
That's gross. It's disgusting.
A raw egg, yeah.
Yeah, no, I'm not doing
that. Okay.
Favorite or most crazy pet?
Ooh, I have a favorite pet.
Yes,
I only have one pet. But...
Do you have a pet other than a dog or a cat? If you do, I would like to see that.
Ooh, that would be cool.
Like an iguana or like one of those like long, is that the long lizard thing? Is that an iguana?
I think an iguana. I think that's what you mean.
Okay.
Those are too good. I actually think we should do several of them.
I don't know. The world's longest slip and slide sounds like it could be dangerous and cold.
You're probably right. Well, you guys keep sending them to the email address below. Remember, the winner not only gets a prize, but you also get to help us host Hang 10 one week.
That's right. For now though, let's check out this week's episode. I actually may come up with some ideas myself for the Challenge of All Challenges. Sorry, I just really like saying that.
It's okay. I actually may do that too. We'll be right back.
Ahoy! Arr, Pete the Pirate here. It's a weird day, ye know. First, me was excited because me haven't seen ye youngins in a while. But then, me sad because me best buddy, Tweety Tweeterson, left me. Me and Tweety, we go way back. We've been best buddies since me was yay high when I was little. He used to dare me to do things like walk the plank when the boat was rocking in the storm. And sometimes he even sang me songs to go to sleep. Hush, little Petey, don't say a word. Tweety's going to find a parrot herd. And if that parrot herd don't fly, Tweety's going to sit down and just cry. Anyways, Tweety Tweeterson used to help me do a lot of things on me ship, but me wasn't the nicest to him. Me loved him. I guess me just had a different way of showing it. Me always tried to correct him, and me wasn't always thankful. Oh, me miss Tweety. Me going to need some time.
Hey guys, welcome back to worship. Today we're gonna teach you the moves to the song, Rise Up Lazarus. So join along with us. Come on and rise up. Take a breath. You're alive now. Can't you hear the voice of Jesus calling us out from the grave like Lazarus? You're brand new. The power of death couldn't hold you. Can't you hear the voice of Jesus calling us out from the grave like Lazarus? Good job, guys. Go ahead and have a seat, and we'll be back to worship with you real soon.
This is a building. Well, it's a church, actually. It is a place where people come together and meet, but it was never meant to be a place where we just show up and get what we need.
What do you mean? I thought church was a place that we go to.
No, actually, we are the church. The church is a group of people who have made God the leader in their lives. And that is us. We may meet in a church, but really we are the church, and we exist for the world.
Oh, that makes sense. No, actually, I still don't get it.
Okay, well, let me try to explain. We all live in our own house, but we were not created to be alone. God taught that we were made to be together. He designed us to have friends and to connect with one another. He created us to depend on and trust other people, not just stay by ourselves and do what we want.
Okay, so God created people to be together, but what does that have to do with the church?
Well, when Jesus first taught about what it looks like to gather, he explained that people should share meals, share their things, help one another, and simply do life together.
Really? He wants us to share everything?
Yeah, that's right. He designed us to be in community, but it's more than just being around other people.
How so?
Well, like I said before, it's doing life together. That means sharing with others when you're worried about things or building each other up and encouraging your friends. It means seeing that everyone is specially made by God and everyone has a part in the world.
Wow, that's hard to do.
Yeah, I know, but we will never understand the depth of God's love when we just keep to ourselves. We have to invite people into our lives and be involved in their lives as well.
That makes sense. We have to care for others and walk through life with them. And when we do, we open the door for them to do the same with us.
Exactly. We can never be too busy for people. Well, because we were created to be with people.
So how do we do this?
We simply love people. Remember, loving them requires action, though. When we love others, we breathe worth and value into who they are.
Right. And well, the truth is, we all need each other. We were all created with intention, and together we can shine God's light to the world.
Again, mateys, have you read this? In 1 Corinthians, it says, "As it are, there be many parts, but there be one body. The eye cannot say to the hand, 'Hey, you get out of here, I don't need you.' And the head cannot say to the feet, 'Me better than you. You're getting the boot.'" It goes on. "If one part suffers, every part suffers. If one part is honored, every part rejoices. Now you are the body of Christ, and each one of you is important." Oh, Tweety Tweeterson. You was important. You was important. Tweety, me so sorry. Let this here be a lesson to each one of you. Everyone matters. We all be together in this world, and we all be needing one another. Me going to go find Tweety and have a talk. Me do have a joke first. What do the ocean say to the pirate? Nothing! It just waves!
Being around a lot of people really is so important.
You mean like doing life with them?
Yeah, I just love being around a lot of people, like going to concerts or sporting events. It's so fun.
It is fun, but I don't think that's what the Bible story was about. It's more than just being around them.
Right, well, we're all there because we want to see the show or watch the game, so we're together.
No, it's not just showing up to enjoy an experience. The Bible story was talking about doing life, sharing things, encouraging others, having real relationships with one another.
Yeah, but I don't really like sharing a lot of things. I think I would rather just keep to myself.
Well, you don't have to tell the whole world everything, but it is important to have people that we are close with so they can pray for us or help us or even encourage us.
Ugh, but then they would know when you do something embarrassing or something wrong.
That's true, but that's okay. None of us are perfect, but we were created by a perfect God, and our perfect God created us to be together, not just like standing close by, but together like loving one another and being friends with one another.
True, but what about people that are hard to get along with?
Even people that are hard to get along with. You know what? We should pray for those people and pray for God to soften our heart toward them. We all have a part to play in the body of Christ.
Oh, that's what the verses in 1 Corinthians mean. It talks about the body of Christ. We all have a part.
Exactly. And not only that, but it's our job to help other people see their gifts and talents so that they can become who God has created them to be.
Wow, that does sound really cool.
Yep. That's what the kingdom of God was designed to be like. We will never fully get there until Jesus returns, but we can see glimpses of his kingdom when we live like he has called us to.
I like that.
Me too. Okay. I think we are out of time. You guys, don't forget about the challenge of all challenges.
Hey, that's my line.
Sorry, I had to do it. That was actually pretty fun.
Do you want to do it together?
Sure.
Okay, send in your ideas to the address below and you may just win the challenge of all challenges.
See you guys next week.
Bye.